G'day students, in this group I'm going to be going over an example on how to solve absolute value equations. So the instructions for this example is to solve the given equation and check your results. Okay? And check your results. Alright, so the problem under consideration is negative 8 minus 2 times the absolute value of 3n minus 2 is equal to negative 40. Okay? Alright, so how do we solve this absolute value equation? So let's do a real quick summary of the steps that we're going to execute to find the value of n. So let's write this down, the steps. The steps are as follows. So first, your number one goal is to isolate the absolute value quantity. So isolate the absolute value quantity. So if you look at this problem right here, this quantity right here is known as the absolute value quantity. So we want to get the absolute value of 3n minus 2 isolated first, okay? So that's the number one step. And then secondly, after doing that, we're going to express as plus or minus, express as plus or minus, and switch over the plus or minus quantity, because you know that the absolute value of a quantity, that's the absolute value of x, can be expressed as plus or minus x. Right, so you express the absolute value as a plus or minus quantity, and then you switch over the plus or minus to the other side, okay? And then the last step you will execute is just to split the equations and solve. Split and solve. Alright? Alright, another thing to note when solving absolute value equations is that there are three possible solutions you can have. You can have two solutions, one solution, or no solution, okay? Well, how is that possible? Well, you can think of the solution to an absolute value equation as intersection between an absolute value function, which is normally in the form of a V, and the line. Okay? Now, if the line intersects anywhere in the graph that's above or below the absolute value quantity opens upwards like this, and the line intersects at a point that's higher than the vertex, like this, how many solutions do you have? You have one solution here, and you have another solution here. Okay, so one possible solution you can have is two solutions. All right, so in this case, you have two solutions. All right. Like I said earlier, there are three possible cases. So you can have two solutions. What if the line intersects the absolute value function exactly at the vertex? If it intersects exactly at the vertex, then in that case, you're going to have exactly one solution, okay? Because there's only one x value that satisfies the equation. So in this case, you have one solution, all right? Now, what if it never intersects? It's a possibility, right? So in this case, you're going to have absolutely no solutions, right? So when you're solving an absolute value equation, it is very important for you to do a check to determine if you have your two solutions are actually solutions, or if you have one solution or no solution, okay? Because you can solve an equation and you have two solutions, and it turns out that one of them is not a solution, or even both of them are not solutions. So you have to be really careful when solving absolute value equations to do a check, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and solve this equation. In the process of solving this, I'll show you one trick you can use to discern if your absolute value equation is going to have solutions or not. Okay, so let's keep that in mind. Now, part one is to isolate the absolute value quantity, okay? So this quantity right here with the absolute value bars around it, I want to isolate it. All right, so to do that, I'll get rid of negative 8 first, and then get rid of negative 2. I'll move it to the other side, all right? So to resolve this negative 8 right here, I'll add 8 to both sides of the equation. And then you have negative 2 times the absolute value of 3n minus 2 is equal to, now negative 40 plus 8 is negative 32. All right, now next thing we're going to do is we're going to divide both sides by negative 2 or multiply by negative 1 half. Let's just divide by negative 2, divide by negative 2. All right, and then here you're going to have the absolute value of 3n minus 2 is equal to positive 16. Now when you get your absolute value quantity isolated, that's a good point to check to see if you have any solutions. Now absolute value is a distance from 0. And the distance can never have a negative value. So anytime you have the absolute value quantity isolated, if the number to the right is negative, that automatically tells you you have no solution. We're going to have this case right here. All right? So that's a quick way to check. So we have the absolute value being equal to a positive number, so we're confident that we have at least one solution. All right? So we're done with step one, which is to isolate the absolute value quantity. Now let's move on to the second step. We're going to express this absolute value as plus or minus 3n minus 2 equals 16. Now to move the plus or minus over, we're going to divide both sides by plus or minus 1. So divide by plus or minus 1, divide this by plus or minus 1. Or you can just move the plus or minus over, it's not a problem. So we're going to have 3n minus 2 equals plus or minus 16. All right, now we have steps number 1 and 2 executed. Now the last step is to split the equation into 2 and solve. How do we do that? How do we split the equation into 2? Well, we have this plus or minus here. It's 2 and 1, so that's where the split happens, all right? We're going to split it into the negative components. 3n minus 2 equals negative 16. And then the positive component, 3n minus 2 equals positive 16. All right? So let's solve the first one. To solve this, we're going to add 2 and divide by 3. Let's go ahead and do that. Add 2 to both sides. You have 3n is equal to negative 14. And then divide both sides by 3. Divide by 3, divide by 3. And then you have n equals negative 14 over 3. Now on this side right here, you're going to add 2. Add 2. And then you get 3n equals 18, divide both sides by 3, and then you have n equals 6. Alright, so our solution sets are negative 14 and 6. So we have to do a check just to make sure that our answers are correct, okay? Even though we watched out earlier on, sometimes you might forget to observe the fact that this equation is false and then you just keep going blindly, but if you do a check, it kind of helps you catch yourself, alright? So we're going to test the first answer, which is n equals negative 14 over 3. We're going to see if it satisfies the original equation, okay? So the question is negative 8 minus 2 times, let's see what the problem is, 3n, okay, minus 2 times 3. Now we're going to plug in the solution we have, which is negative 14 over 3. That minus 2. Is it equal to negative 40? That's the question. All right, let's go ahead and simplify this. We have negative 8 minus 2. These 3 and these 3 cancels out. So we have absolute value of negative 14 minus 2. Is that equal to negative 40? Let's work further. Negative 8 minus 2 minus 14 minus 2 is minus 16. Is that equal to negative 40? Now we're going to have negative 8 minus 2, absolute value of 6, negative 16 is 16. Is it equal to negative 40? And then you're going to have negative 8 minus 32. Is it equal to negative 40? And then the final question is negative 40 equal to negative 40? The answer is yes. So we're confident that our first solution is in fact correct. All right, let's check the second one. Check n equals 6. So the question here is negative 8 minus 2 times 3 times plug in the answer we got, which is 6. 3 times 6 minus 2 is it equal to negative 40? That was the question. All right, let's work it out. Negative 8, if we simplify this, we're going to have negative 2 times 3 times 2 is 6 is 18. 18 minus 2, absolute value, is it equal to negative 40? And then negative 8 minus 2, 18 minus 2 is 16, absolute value of 16. Is it equal to negative 40? Absolute value of negative 16. Now you have to be careful here. Some people change this to negative 16. So absolute value of positive 16 is just 16. So 2 times 16, is it equal to negative 40? Using our order of operations, multiply first. Negative 8 minus 32, is it equal to negative 40? Negative 8 minus 32 is negative 40. Is negative 40 equal to negative 40? The answer is yes. So that works out also, okay? So we're confident that our solutions are going to be n is equal to negative 14 over 3 and positive 6. All right, so that's that. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. You can feel free to subscribe to my channel by clicking here for all these other cool audio tool clips such as this. Please feel free to post a comment to let me know what you think about this clip. And if you liked it, do give me a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. More clips can be found on microsoft.com/algebra2.html. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.